Hello students, welcome to standard 9 subject mathematics. Now we are going to start the chapter number 11, construction. This is lecture number 1. About the construction, in earlier classes also we have seen how to draw the different type of angles, how to draw the bisector of the angle, how to draw the bisector of given line segment also. So that's why we will recall some knowledge about the construction in this lecture. So we have called this as basic constructions because we have seen in earlier classes these all. So the first construction in our course is, in basic construction, is construction 11.1. It is to construct a bisector of given angle. Let the given angle is ABC. The given is angle is ABC given this way. And what our work here? What to construct? We have to construct the bisector of this angle ABC. We have to draw the bisector. Bisector means, you know, which is dividing anything in two equal parts. So this angle ABC is there of this much, some angle, some degree angle. We have to draw a ray in such a way that it should bisect the given angle ABC. Means dividing in two equal parts. So in construction, we will draw how to draw the bisector of angle. So we required the all compass, pencil extra, scale, eraser, sharpener, everything we need. So you are suggested to have an instrumental box, mathematical geometrical instrument box, in which all the things must be. Now we start one by one the step. This is the given angle. We want to draw the bisector of this given angle. So first step is, we have to take the center as B. Center as B means our rounder point we have to take on B point this way. And any radius, you can take any radius. This, the distance between the point, rounder point and pencil point, is called radius. We take any radius. So I am taking this much of radius and taking the rounder point on B, that is called this, taking the B as center and any radius. We have to draw an arc intersecting the ray BA and BC. This is ray BA and this is ray BC. Both should be intersected by that arc. So that way we will draw, taking the center as B, means rounder point on B, taking some radius, draw an arc this way. This arc is intersecting BA and BC both, and say there BA and BC, where it is intersecting, say at E and D. Wherever on BA it intersects, say there E point, and where it intersects BC, say there at D point. Right? This way D and E point we have. Now next, taking the center as D and E respectively, means we have to take our rounder on D first, that is called, the taken the center as D, and after that we will take the center as E. So first we will taking the center as D, and how much radius? More than half of DE. So you know that this is DE distance, or more than that. Half is this, more than that, this way. The DE distance, half is this. We have to take the radius half, more than half. So more than half distances of DE you have to take, and take the center as D. Draw this way an arc here, taking the center as D and more than half length of, more than half of DE as radius. Now similar radius we have to take, and now take the center as E, and by the similar same radius that we have taken previously, intersect the previously drawn arc this way. This is the second step. So we have, what we have done, we have taken the rounder on D, that means center as D, and then we have taken the center as E, that means rounder on E, and both the time we have taken the radius more than half of D. Draw arcs, we have drawn the arcs, intersect each other, they are intersecting each other say at F. Wherever they are intersecting each other, say that point as F. This way. Now next, what to do? Draw the ray BF. Ray BF we have to draw. Means initial is B and towards F we have to draw this way. Ray BF. This ray BF is the required bisector of the angle, given angle ABC. So you have seen very simply the bisector of given angle we can draw using these steps. In exam, if it is asked, you have to write this way. Of the construction, you have to read carefully, and given things you have to write in given, and whatever you want to construct in that, you have to write in to construct. And then construction means the figure we have to show here, how we are constructing that we have to show there. And then we will write the steps. In the steps, we will write whatever we have done in the figure to draw. Step by step, we have to write about it all. And this way, the construction is finished. It when we ask of 3 or 4 marks, which is in the exam. So you are suggested to see this video 1 or 2 times. If you don't understand, you see more times and construct yourself again in your way and do the practice of this. Thank you.